no one came back to tea. And around about December, the cards upon his shelf,
which wished him lots of Christmas cheer and fortune in the coming year, were never from his near and dear, but only from himself.
John was not a good man, yet he had his hopes and fears. They had given him no thought of power for years and years and years.
But yet every year at Christmas, while Bruce was still alive, the little tribute from the young of all the songs they might have sung, he stole away upstairs and hung her home for stocking out.
John was out of the now, lived his life a living, learned what he's done.
All that sundry knit and flat at Christmas in particular, the sign of Mojo hand us up, but very hungry Jack.
I want some crackers and I want some candy. I think a box of chocolates would come in rather handy. Don't mind oranges, I do like nuts.
And I should look at them, really beautiful.
And no Father Christmas, if you look at all, bring me big, red and yellow ball.
King John was not a good man. He wrote this message out and got to his room again, descending by the spout. And all that night he lay there,
I think that fear will come in now, anxiety within his brow. He'll bring on prison anyhow, the first I had for years.
I don't want crackers and I don't want candy. I'm sure lots of chocolates will never come in handy. I don't like oranges and I don't want nuts.
And I have a pocket knife that really, really cuts.
But oh, Father Christmas, if you love me at all, bring me a big bed in year of the ball.
And crackers, toys and games with him, and licked his sticky sweets with King John so grumpy, as I feared, nothing again for me.
I did want crackers and I did want candy. I know I've got some chocolate with our cup in handy. I do love oranges, I did want nuts.
And oh, if Father Christmas had loved me at all, he would have brought me a big red India rubber ball. Then King John stood by the window and frowned his head.
The happy memories of boys and girls all came in sight.
While he stood there watching,
and through the window, big and red, that hurtled by his royal head, that bounced and fell upon his head, and through the arrow of all.
And oh, Father Christmas, my blessings on you fall, for bringing him a big red India rubber ball.
I was his queen, so true to me was half of everything.
He ate a rocky poppy pop. Grandmama was full and tough. Wolfie went, "That's not enough.
I haven't yet begun to feel that I have had a decent meal." He went around the kitchen yelping, "I've got to have a second helping." Then I didn't feel a fight for me. I'm therefore going to wait right here until the little is spent riding hook comes on from walking in the woods.
He quickly put on Grandma's purse. Of course he had a big nose. He dressed himself in a coat and hat. He put on shoes and after that.
He even brushed and curled his hair. Then sat himself in Grandma's chair. In came the little girl in red. She stopped, she stared, and then she said,
"What great big ears you have, Grandma. More for better to live in. More for blind. What great big eyes you have, Grandma. More for better to see you."
He sat there watching her and smiling. He thought, "I'm going to eat this child. Compared with her old grandmama, she's going to taste like caviar." And the little red riding hood said, "But my grandma, what a lovely light great big fur coat you have on."
"That's wrong," cried Wolf.
"Have you forgot to tell me what big teeth I've got?" "Well, no matter what you say, I'm going to eat you anyway." The small girl smiled one eyelid flick as she whips a pistol from her knickers. She aims it at the creature's head and bang, 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 she shoots it dead. A few weeks later in the wood, I came across this riding hood. But what a change, no cloak of red, no silly hood upon her head. She said, "Hello, and please your note, lovely furry wolfy coat."
This is a house, the jackets. This is a mouse, the lame, the house, the jackets. Father.